When we look at these uptrend lines, we want to incorporate multiple time horizons. That's the first thing that we talked about, right? One of the advantages that we have as technicians is starting from a structural perspective, getting long-term views of the market, and then working our way short-term. And we could do the same thing with trend lines. So in this case, we're looking at that same technology exchange-traded fund, the XLK. Here's the short-term trend line that we just mentioned that connects the troughs from 2016 through 2017. But taking it one step further, this uptrend line goes back to the 2009 lows. So we start from a structural perspective. We have a beautiful uptrend, higher highs and higher lows for a decade above an uptrend line connecting those troughs. And then if you zoom in, you can see that there is another uptrend, a shorter term uptrend above the uptrend line within a structural uptrend. That's what we want to see. So if technology were to break the shorter term, steeper uptrend, we know from experience that there is support below from the longer term trend. Once that starts to break, if indeed it does, then we know from a structural perspective, things have definitely changed, not just a break in the near term. So incorporating that multiple time frame approach, not just with chart construction, but actually with trend lines as well, is a tremendous advantage. So here's a great example of how we can incorporate trend lines in our analysis. We're looking at gold futures. This goes back to 2015, 2016. This was the peak in gold in the summer of 2016. Beautiful downtrend line connecting all of the peaks in the gold market. Notice how we have a downward sloping 200-day moving average. So now we're incorporating some of the things that we've already talked about and using them to our advantage with our trend identification. So with gold but making lower highs below a downtrend line and a downward sloping 200-day moving average, we know the trend is not up. In all likelihood, it's either sideways or down. So the breakout, the attempted breakout that we saw in gold in the spring of 2017 failed. The downtrend line, the moving average, all of these things helped and came into play. So now what happened next? Not only did we not hold the breakout above the downtrend line in gold, but now we're breaking the uptrend lines in gold, going back to the lows in 2016. And I think this is a great point. Don't be afraid to draw multiple trend lines. Don't be afraid to erase a trend line either and draw a new one. In this case, we have an uptrend line from the December lows in gold that has broken. And we have a less steep uptrend line from the January lows in gold that also broke. So remember, this is not an exact science. This is an art. And in many cases, the trend line that works the sweetest, the one that connects all of those troughs, doesn't necessarily have to be the absolute low. In many cases, it's that first higher low, that second low, if you will, where that trend line should begin. So don't be afraid to draw multiple trend lines.